To live with diabetes means relying on regular blood glucose tests multiple times per day. This is because glucose levels can vary depending on the time of day, the time you eat, your activity levels, and even hormonal changes. But to get an idea of overall changes in glucose levels requires a different type of test. That's why doctors utilize the HbA1c test in order to get a several-month overview of your blood sugar balance. So, what sort of score should you try to achieve for this test? And which methods can you utilize today to improve your long-term readings? We're about to unveil three amazing tips for lowering your HbA1c levels. Like, subscribe, and stay tuned for three free gifts. And to really show your appreciation, you can always click the thanks button. Okay, how does this mysterious test work exactly? What will the results mean for you? And how can you ensure your next HbA1c test stays in a healthy range? Let's find out. The top three tips for reducing HbA1c levels. So, what is this test exactly? It looks at your blood glucose levels over a period of 3 months and measures the amount of sugar that clings to the protein known as hemoglobin, which is found in red blood cells. Typically, HbA1c levels should be kept under a rating of 6 to 7%. For diabetics, a healthy level of HbA1c will depend on an individual's treatment plan. However, if your HbA1c levels rise above 7%, you are more at risk of experiencing diabetes complications, including developing diabetes mellitus. So let's investigate three powerful tips for improving your next HbA1c test. Tip number three, eat a healthy diet. Yeah, seems obvious, right? But then again, it can be tricky to fully understand which specific foods to eat and which to avoid. After all, what you eat can make a huge difference in how your blood glucose responds on a day-to-day basis. By eating a regulated and healthy diet, you can work towards improved numbers on your next HbA1c test. For diabetics, and really for everyone, a healthy diet should be comprised of a variety of nutrients, including mono and polyunsaturated fats, lean proteins, complex carbohydrates, fiber, plus a variety of vitamins, antioxidants, and minerals, while staying away from saturated and trans fats, and of course, simple carbohydrates, meaning processed sugar. Eating a balanced diet and acquiring the right combination of nutrients on a regular basis has been proven to improve insulin sensitivity, reduce inflammation, decrease blood lipids, regulate blood glucose levels, and improve HbA1c scores. In fact, a recent study of type 2 diabetic participants found that consuming appropriate amounts of fiber on a daily basis can significantly regulate HbA1c levels. A separate study investigating the effect of fruit and vegetable intake on HbA1c scores found that eating a diet rich in fruits and vegetables may work to develop antioxidant defense, which can reduce glycosylated hemoglobin. Thus, the study concluded that eating fruits and vegetables can reduce HbA1c readings in diabetic patients. To eat a healthy and diabetic-friendly diet, it is recommended to generously include fatty fish, leafy greens, nuts and seeds, Greek yogurt, beans, and berries to your daily diet. Of course, you are not limited to just these foods. As long as your plate is varied and includes foods of a wide range of healthy sources of carbohydrates, protein, and fat, you will provide your body with plenty of nutrients which can help regulate HbA1c levels. Tip number two, try the diabetes plate method. Just like your short-term post-meal glucose levels, maintaining healthy HbA1c levels can come down to the foods on your plate. And that means it's not only about finding the highest quality macronutrients, you also need to acquire the right kinds and proper amounts of specific micronutrients. That's where the diabetes plate method and food pairing comes into play. Each ingredient you choose to include in your meal should provide a specific group of nutrients which can work together inside your body to improve the health of a wide range of diabetes-related functions. But the great news is, if you simply choose nutrient-rich options of your three main macronutrients, that being carbs, proteins, and fats, you will also be supplying your body with a full library of micronutrients. With the diabetes plate method, simply break down your plate into three sections. Half of the plate for veggies and leafy greens, a quarter of the plate for lean protein, and the final quarter for whole grains and other complex carbohydrate foods. So, for example, you can create a filling and delicious meal with half a plate of spinach salad, with cucumbers, tomatoes, walnuts, and feta cheese. Fill a quarter of your plate with a sautéed or baked boneless skinless chicken breast. And then feel free to enjoy a slice of 100% whole grain bread, a small serving of cooked quinoa, or even a modest portion of cooked chickpeas or black beans. Separating your plate in this manner ensures that you receive the right amount of muscle-strengthening proteins, heart-helping fats, energy-providing carbohydrates, and diabetes-fighting micronutrients to keep blood glucose and HbA1c levels regulated, without having to measure everything you eat by the gram. In fact, a randomized study of 150 type 2 diabetic participants observed that those who followed the diabetes plate method for 6 months experienced an average 10% improvement in their HbA1c levels. So, maybe the diabetes plate method is right for you. Make sure to speak with your doctor or dietitian to determine the specific foods and portion sizes which can work for your body and your lifestyle. We've got one last tip for reducing your HbA1c levels. But real quick, are you ready for 3 free gifts? Discover a world of positive nutrition within our exclusive book, Superfoods for Diabetics. Get exclusive insights from some of the world's leading medical and nutritional professionals by watching episode 1 of that diabetes documentary. And discover carefully crafted diabetes-fighting recipes in our new cookbook, Snacks, Meals, and Desserts That Lower Blood Sugar. Grab all 3 amazing free gifts by clicking the link in the description below. And now, here comes our top tip for improved HbA1c levels. Tip number 1. Exercise regularly. Pairing a controlled and healthy diet with exercise can be extremely beneficial if you're looking to better regulate your HbA1c levels. During aerobic exercise, muscles contract. This process forces glucose into muscle cells, where it is then burned as a source of energy. So, when you perform moderate physical activities, like jogging, cycling, or even simply walking, your body will naturally lower your blood glucose levels. Over time, regular physical activity can help you achieve reduced HbA1c levels as well. You can also utilize a wide range of other fun and effective cardio exercises to aid your glucose control and your HbA1c levels. Try swimming, dancing, or even yoga. You can even count housework, like cleaning or mowing, as forms of aerobic activity. But whatever routine you choose, studies show that aerobic movement in any form can work to lower your HbA1c readings. In fact, a recent study revealed that type 2 diabetic participants who completed 90 minutes of aerobic activity 3 times per week significantly improved their HbA1c levels. Most doctors believe that diabetics should aim for about 150 minutes of aerobic exercise per week. So, find your favorite physical activities and incorporate them into your everyday lifestyle. Not only will aerobic exercise aid your glucose control and help to increase weight loss, these regular body movements will work to reduce your long-term blood sugar readings as well. Overall, regulating your HbA1c levels all comes down to your lifestyle habits. Adjust how you eat and how you move in between eating to get your long-term glucose levels within a healthy range. And now, we want to hear from you. What habits do you use to reduce your HbA1c levels? Share your thoughts with our community in the comment section below. It might just help someone in need. Please like this vid, make sure to subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to claim your 3 free gifts by clicking the link in the description below. We're Diabetes Smarts, and it's our mission to bring you the best tips and tricks to help you fight obesity and diabetes. Thanks for watching. We hope you're having a diabetes-fighting day.